So, do you know what? This actually sums me up. This is a book I made when I was like 18, and it's called 15 Minutes of Fame. I literally wrote that on there. So it says, enjoying my 15 minutes of celeb fame after X Factor and my celeb encounters. So clearly I was thinking, this won't last. Dare to dream. Today we're in East London at the Vatican Studios, and we're rehearsing for my show at Union Chapel on March the 16th. And I'm feeling really excited today, very emotional. It's a very poignant week for me. And the day before my show will be 3 years since my dad passed away. And he was the person that nurtured my love of music. And so I feel really connected to my dad, like doing this show and putting everything together. Yeah, it's gonna be a tough gig to get through for sure. Today is the first time I've heard the band play all the songs live. I've left Kat to it. She's the MD. She's been amazing. She's put everybody together. I've trusted her ear. And as soon as I got in there today, I've just heard it. And it's like, everyone's been playing together for like 5 years. It's really tight and it sounds amazing. We've decided to split the rehearsals over two spaces. So we've got Kat with the band in one room and then Beth with the dancers in another room. So the dance and the performance is one side and then the musical direction is a completely different side. Being the singer, I have to run in between the rooms, and it kind of describes the battle that I have internally as a performer anyway. Because I've always loved to sing, but I also really love to dance and perform. So I'm always torn between the two.
We've been in here in the studio now, just the dancers. So she's got two female dancers, which is Kelechi and Lili. And so we've been working through all the performances that require choreography. Because the show's so long, it's 90 minutes, it's got a lot of light and shade in it. So what will happen is that there'll be a song with dancers, and then it'll drop down to just Fleur on her own. And at one point, it's going to be just Fleur totally without the band. So it's got to find the points where she can dance and the points where she needs to really hone down on her vocal, because her songs are very, very powerful. They require a lot of breath. So you have to find those points.
We've been dancing in the studio today, going through all of the songs one by one, breaking down the choreography, breaking down the routine, and I'm really excited to break out into some of the dance sequences, because a lot of them are like a little bit of a surprise and I don't think people will be expecting where they are. So it's gonna be a lot of fun.
During Strictly, one of me and Vito's highest scored dances was our samba, and that's notoriously one of the most difficult dances to learn. In rehearsals, we used to play my song, There She Go, to practice with. And so when I was putting the set list together for this show, There She Go was on the set list. And I was like, it all makes sense. Vito has to dance with me in the song. And as soon as I asked him, he just jumped at the chance.
Take you like this, but don't let she go. Face so pretty with a heart so cold. Sure they need
For me, it's so unbelievable because, of course, for me, the first time to see Fleur, you know, like Fleur East. So I've been and I've lived months with Fleur, you know, the celeb dancing. And now, I mean, she's like, I mean, so wonderful. I love to just observe how she's singing, how she moves, how she performs, how she just acts, you know. So I'm just, you know, grateful because I'm happy to be here. I'm so excited. I cannot wait to perform. And I'm so, so proud of this human being. So amazing. So amazing.
It's been really interesting coming from my world of music to his world of Latin and ballroom. That was like completely removed from anything that I do. Although it was dance I've never done before. So I was so out of my comfort zone and like under his mercy kind of thing. He was in control. Now he's coming to my world.
Yeah.
And I have the control back.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's fun and I've learned so much doing Strictly. Like it's so weird even being with you today and learning that routine. If you taught me that at the beginning of Strictly, I would have really struggled with that. I would have really struggled. But now it's like, oh yeah, just spin, go around, rondé. Like I know what it means. Like it's it's crazy.
Perfect student.
There's a lot that I need to cram in around rehearsals, including a breakfast show on the radio every morning.
And it's so rewarding because on my radio show, I mean, I've got the chance to interview these incredible artists, like these people that I never thought I'd be in the same room as. So I'm getting so much inspiration from them while I'm interviewing them. And then I get to take that into rehearsals, which is amazing. Since the first day, we've come a long way. I've been doing everything separately. So I've been rehearsing with the band and then rehearsing with the dancers, but it's all been very, very disconnected. And now's the first time we've all come together and it feels right. Like it feels like we've all been in the same room from the start, which is amazing. I think now I know that the show is tomorrow. I can't wait now. I'm itching to get on the stage, but I'm still trying to soak up every minute of this because this is a really nice time when we all get to just practice, just feel it, just get in the vibe. I don't want to wish it away. I want to try and enjoy it all. First run through of the entire set done, and now I'm like, okay, it's kind of in my head a bit more, like I'm feeling the vibes, I'm feeling the energy, I can kind of monitor where I need to like breathe, where I need to put in all the energy, but it felt amazing, and the band are so good, the dancers are on fire, so I just need to match all of their energy and bring it.
That would be sick actually, if you could do. You better play better sets.
So what I'll do then, before Silk Sonic, rather than go on about Bruno, because I wanted to add like a little thing of and embarrass my mum of like how the reason I'm obsessed with it so much is because it throws back to like that 70s, 80s vibe and the music my parents listened to growing up and how my parents used to have parties in the house all the time. And the reason I can sleep anywhere at any time is because my mother gave me good training. Because she used to let us nap in the corner of the living room while they were having parties all night long.
And literally just really embarrass her. And I'd be like, no judgment, mum, not judging. I'm not judging you. But I'd be like, yeah, she used to sing. She was like, holiday, celebrate.
That's cute.
You know what I mean? Yeah. I know I'm not really going to sleep tonight because I'm going to be running through everything in my head. I'm going to try my best to sleep. It's not going to happen. But then I'm just going to be running on adrenaline tomorrow. I definitely won't be able to sleep after the show because I'll just be buzzing. I'm looking forward to it now.